Good morning, students. I am M. Venkataya, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Vignesh Lara Institute of Technology. So now I am going to teach the subject is thermal and hydro prime movers. So earlier in the previous class, what I have to tell is the thermal and the and hydro prime movers, the different types of hydro prime movers and thermal prime movers. So here in previous class, what I have explained the IC engine terminology and working principle of four stroke IC engine. Now I am going to repeat once again here the IC engine terminology. So what is meant by IC engine terminology? So the IC engine terminology means internal combustion engines. So the internal combustion engine, the terminology is, first of all, first one is bore. What is meant by bore? Bore is a inside diameter of the cylinder. So the inside diameter of the cylinder is called bore. We can call it as bore. Okay. And next, second point is top dead center. So what is meant by top dead center? So the top dead center is nothing but TDC. So that you can shortly call it as TDC. So the TDC, what is meant by TDC? The piston moves from extreme top of the cylinder is called the top dead center. Okay. And the bottom dead center. So the piston moves from extreme bottom of the center. Bottom of the center is called bottom dead center. And next, coming to the stroke, what is meant by stroke? The piston moves from TDC to BDC. So top dead center to BDC, we can call it as stroke. And the piston will move from BDC to DDC, BDC to TDC, then we can call it as another stroke. That is called revolution. One revolution equal to two strokes. That is the main important thing here. And the working principle of four stroke IC engine. So the working principle of internal combustion engine. In previous, what I have to tell is the working principle of IC engine is the four stroke cylinder. So it have four stroke is there. First one is intake stroke. Second one is compression stroke. Third one is power stroke. Fourth one is exhaust stroke. So what is meant by intake stroke? So intake stroke is nothing but that is the fresh air plus fuel mixing into the cylinder. At that time, the piston will move from top dead center to bottom dead center. At that particular time is called intake stroke. And then coming to the compression stroke, the piston will move from bottom dead center to top dead center. So we can call it as compression stroke. At that time, the vacuum, the air fuel mixture will compressed at that time, and it is a heat generated at that combustion chamber. So that is 2500 watt will be created. So that is second stroke is completed. Then the coming to the power stroke. So at that power stroke, so we have in the combustion chamber 2500 volt will be created. At that time, the spark ignited. That is power stroke or expansion stroke. So power here, the ignited in the combustion chamber, that is ignited. So the air fuel mixture is burns. At that time, piston have some energy. That energy will transfer to crankshaft with the help of connecting rod. So that crankshaft will connect to the clutch box. That clutch box will connect to the gearbox. That gearbox will connect it to back of the wheel of the cars or bikes. That is the main function here. Okay. And coming to the fourth, exhaust stroke. So the exhaust stroke, what will happen here is the burns, the gases will move out to the exhaust valve. That is the main thing. And now I am going to explain today's class is working principle of two stroke IC engine and comparisons and advantages of 4 stroke and 2 stroke IC engines. So first we have to talk about the working principle of 2 stroke internal combustion engine. Then comparison and advantages of 4 stroke and 2 stroke engine. So comparison, advantages, what is the advantages and the disadvantages also I mentioned here. And first I want to discuss about the working principle of 2 stroke engine. So we have to see the basic parts of the 2 stroke petrol engine. So I am choosing here the petrol engine. So that's why the basic parts of the 2 stroke petrol engine, the cylinder block, piston rings, spark plug, connecting rod, followed by the crankshaft. So we have to see here, so cylinder head, this is the cylinder head, first part, and the piston, so we have to see, this is the piston, and piston rings, these are the piston rings. And spark plug, we have spark plug, and connecting rod, this is the connecting rod, and crankshaft, this is the crankshaft, like this. So first of all, what is meant by cylinder block here? The cylinder block is bore, inner side, we can call it as bore, that is inner side of the cylinder is called cylinder block. And the piston is the main part of the engine. It compresses the air fuel mixture, and the main function is the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center. Is it clear? And piston rings. So here two types of piston rings is there. That is, one is compression ring and second one is oil ring. So compression ring is we can also know the upper ring, and the lower ring is called oil ring. And spark plug. So spark plug we are using nowadays, we are using any bikes and cars also. And connecting rod. So the main part of the connecting rod is the piston has some energy that will transfer to crankshaft with the help of connecting rod. And the crankshaft, the crankshaft will rotates the reciprocating motion to the rotary motion. That is the main part of the engine. Not only these parts, this is a very, each and every part is very important of IC engines, internal combustion engines. If there is no any piston or spark plug, engine will never moves forward. That is the main thing. That's why it is a very important thing here. And next, first of all I want to explain about the cylinder. So we have to see here the cylinder block, it is the heart of the engine. The cylinder in which the piston slides up and down. So up and down, in the bore of the cylinder the charges is compressed by the piston. So we have to see here, it is the heart of the engine. The block, the cylinder block is the heart of the engine. And the piston moves inside the cylinder, the piston moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center, and bottom dead center to the bottom dead center to the top dead center. So we have to see here, in the bore of the cylinder, the charges is compressed by the piston. So we have to see, this is the bore. This is the bore of the cylinder. Okay, is it clear? And next part is piston. So it is the main active part of the engine. So inside the engine, the main part of the engine is the piston. So we have to see here the piston diagram of this one is the piston, and the main function is to compress the fresh charge during the compression stroke. So we have to see here the compression, to compress the fresh charge. So fresh charge in the sense of, if you take fresh charge here, the air plus fuel, that is intake port, and intake valves. In four-stroke engine, we have to take the valve, and in two-stroke engines, we have to take ports. So here, the fresh charge in the sense of air plus fuel. Fuel in the, if you take the petrol, petrol fuel. If you take a diesel, diesel fuel. If you take gases, gases. So air plus fuel. So air plus charge means air plus fuel. That is petrol, diesel and gases. Okay. And next part, the piston rings. So the piston ring is two types of piston rings is there. One is a compression ring, we can call it as the upper ring, and the lower ring is called the oil ring. So the main function of the piston ring is to prevent the leakages of the lubricating oil into the cylinder. So to avoid the leakages, the main function of the piston rings is to avoid the leakages of the lubricating oil into the cylinder. That is the main thing. So we have to see here, this is a piston ring. So this one is upper piston ring, that is compression. This is the lower, that is oil ring. Oil ring. The main function of the piston ring is to avoid the leakages of the lubricating oil into the cylinder. That is the main thing. Okay. And next part is spark plug. So we are using the spark plug in bikes and cars also. So it is the electric match used to begin the combustion process of burning air and the petrol to create a heat. So ultimate aim is here to create a heat. That's why we are using the spark plug. And the connecting rod. So the connecting rod connects the piston to the crankshaft with the help of connecting rod. The main function of the connecting rod is it transmits the power produces in the cylinder to the crankshaft. So here the piston, we have to see here, this is the connecting rod. The piston have some energy, that energy will convey to crankshaft with the help of connecting rod. That is the main thing and main important part in connecting rod. So the piston energy, it will convey to crankshaft. That crankshaft will connect it to the clutch box. So that clutch box will connect it to gearbox. That gearbox will connect it to back of the wheel of the bikes or cars, whatever it is. Then it will move forward. So the main concept of this one. And the crank and crankshaft. So here we have to see here, the crank is a lever. It connects the bigger end of the connecting rod to the crankshaft. So the crank is a lever that is connects crankshaft and the piston rod. Piston rod is nothing but the connecting rod. The crankshaft is the principal rotating part of the engine. So the main part of the crankshaft is the principal rotating part. So it is the rotating reciprocating motion to the rotary motion. The main concept of this crank and the crankshaft. Is it clear? And next, this is the two-stroke petrol engine. So we have to see here, two-stroke in the sense of two strokes are available here. That is upward stroke and downward stroke. So we have to see here, the upward stroke, that is the clockwise direction, and the downward stroke also, that is the clockwise direction. So we have to see here this is the valve opens, valve in the sense of the carburetor valve. What is the main function of the carburetor is first to receive the air plus fuel mixture. Air plus fuel to send the air fuel mixture at the ratio of air fuel ratio. The main function of carburetor is to receive the air fuel and to send the air fuel mixture at particular ratio of air fuel. That is the main thing of a carburetor. So we have here one carburetor is there, and Here one tank is there, that is oil tank and carburetor is there. So we have to see here, fuel mixture is drawn into the crankcase. So the fuel mixture into the, this is a crankcase, this one is crankcase. So the fuel into the inlet port with the help of crank will send to the transfer port is opens here covered, and the air fuel mixture into the combustion chamber. So the fuel is compressed and ignited. At that time the piston moves from bottom dead center to the top dead center, at the time the fuel is compressed. At that time with the spark plug we have ignited. When the ignited, that piston have energy, that energy will convey to the crankshaft with the help of cramping rod. At that time in the upward direction the burning fuel forces piston down, compressing the fuel mixture in crankcase. That is the main thing here. And after that the upward cases, piston will move from top dead center to the bottom dead center. At that time the wastage gases will send out. That is the main thing of downward stroke. So we have the downward stroke, that is downward intake port is covered and walls forced closed. After that the transfer port is unconventional and fuel mixture forced into the cylinder. That is the main thing. After that the piston moves from top dead center to the BDC, bottom dead center, TDC to BDC. Burned fuel is pushed out by the compression fuel mixtures. So waste gases will send out to the exhaust port. So this is the two stroke petrol engine overall diagram. So two strokes in the sense of upward stroke and downward stroke. And coming to the two stroke petrol engine, so we have to see here, this is the two stroke petrol engine of cross section. And what is meant by cross section, I already tell the previous classes also. So cross section, we know that we have the cross section in the 90 degrees axis of that one. So we have to see here the two stroke engine. So two stroke engine is an internal combustion engine. So what is meant by internal combustion engine? So here the internal combustion engine is a device which transforms the chemical energy into heat energy. That heat energy will convey to mechanical work or mechanical energy, then it's called the heat engine. So that is the one type. This is the one internal combustion engine that completes the forces cycle in one revolution of the crankshaft. So first of all, what is meant by revolution? So revolution in the sense of two strokes equal to one revolution. So that is the two stroke means the piston moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center, then it's called one stroke is completed. Then the piston moves bottom dead center to the top dead center is called another stroke. So we can say at that time one revolution is completed. So two stroke equal to one revolution. That is main thing here. Thus one power stroke is obtained in each revolution of the crankshaft. That is the main thing. And next, two stroke petrol engine, we have to see, this is the animation of two stroke petrol engine. So we have to see here, this is the downward stroke and upward stroke. Downward stroke, upward stroke. We have to see, it has only three ports is there here. In compared to four stroke engine, it has in the four stroke engine have two valves, that is inlet valve and the outlet valve. Coming to the two stroke engine, it have three ports, that is one port is inlet port. We have to see here, this is the inlet port. And this is the transfer. transverse port. This one is exhaust port. So first entering the fuel mixture, that is the air, fresh charge into the cylinder with the help of crankcase. With the help of crankcase, that say that fuel mixture will enter to the combustion chamber. At that time, combustion chamber. At that time, that is compressed the air. At that time, here the spark, with the help of spark plug, it is ignited. When the ignited, the piston have some energy. That energy will transfer to the crankshaft. The crankshaft will transfer to clutch box, and that is clutch box will connected to the gearbox. Gearbox will connected to the back of the wheel of the bikes or car, and it will move forward. That is the main reason here. So we have to see, this is the animation of two stroke petrol engine. The two stroke is upward direction and downward direction. So this is the upward direction and downward direction. Upward direction, downward direction, we have to see here. And coming to the working of two stroke petrol engine. So we have to see here the two stroke petrol engine. Here suction and exhaust strokes are eliminated. So when compared to four stroke engine have four strokes. First stroke is intake stroke, second stroke is compression stroke, third stroke is power stroke, fourth stroke is exhaust. So but here we have to observe in the two stroke petrol engine. So we have to see here suction and exhaust strokes are eliminated. So suction stroke and exhaust stroke is eliminated, and instead of valves, ports are used. So from four stroke engines we have used two valves. So but here the two stroke engines, internal combustion engines, so we are using in place of valves in place of ports. So we are using the ports here only. That ports is inlet port and transition port and exhaust port. So the exhaust gases are deviation deriving out of the cylinder by the fresh charge entering the cylinder. So when the fresh charge in the sense of air plus fuel we are entering in of the cylinder by the fresh charge entering the cylinder. That is the main thing here. And the intake and exhaust are controlled by movement of piston. So here in two stroke engines we are maintaining the movements of exhaust port and the inlet port. We are maintaining the moves from piston moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center and bottom dead center to the top dead center. At that time the ports in the sense of inlet port and the exhaust ports are observed here. And when compared to the four stroke engines, from there the cam wheel operates at the right time of and right timings also. And the charges is compressed by the pumping action of the piston due to the design of crankcase. So we have to see here the design of the crankcase based on the design of the crankcase to design of crankcase, the charges is compressed. The charge means air plus fuel mixture is compressed by the pumping action of the piston due to the design of the crankcase. And as the piston continues to move upward, exhaust and transfer ports get closed and the compression is continued. That is the thing. And coming to the, in the end of the compression, the spark is created. So after completion of compression, at that time the spark is created. Okay, is it clear? And it ignites the charges and the products of combination thrust the piston from top dead center to the bottom dead center. Okay, and this cycle is repeated continuously. So this cycle is repeated continuously. Then the bikes are and cars, it will move forward regularly. So this is the thing, the main working principle of that one. And the coming to the advantages of two stroke petrol engines. So we have to see here, the power developed will be nearly twice that of four stroke engine. So we have to see here, the power developed will be nearly twice. So nearly, it is a nearly twice that of four stroke engine. So when compared to four stroke engine, it has twice. Okay, the work repeated the work required to overcome the friction of the exhaust and suction stroke is same, and the low weight construction is simple. So it is a very low weight, and it is the construction of the two stroke engine is a simple. So if this is the some of the advantages of two stroke engines. So once again I repeat it, that is a low weight, the power developed will be nearly twice that of the four stroke engines, like that. And construction, it is the construction is a very simple for that two stroke engines. And here the disadvantage, coming to the disadvantages of the two stroke engines. So as a working on auto cycle, auto cycle, what is meant by auto cycle? So the 8 standard cycles, and I am going to explain in next class 8 standard cycles and valve and port timing diagrams. At the time I will explain clearly auto cycle. So now as a working on auto cycle, a part of the fresh mixture is lost through exhaust port. Part of the piston stroke is lost. Heavy consumption of lubricating oil. So here the heavy consumption of lubricating oil, that is the consumption means in the sense of utilizing. So heavy consumption of lubricating oil, we are utilizing high amount of lubricating oil we are using. That's why there is some of the disadvantages for this two stroke petrol engine. And comparison of four stroke and two stroke cylinder cycle engine. So comparison of four stroke two stroke cycle engines. So we have to see here, the cycle is completed in four strokes of piston and in two revolution of crankshaft. So yeah, we have to see here, the cycle is completed. When the cycle is completed in four stroke and two revolutions. So we have four stroke engine, two cycles in the sense of two revolutions, four strokes. So one stroke, two strokes equal to one revolution. So two revolution equal to four strokes. But coming to the two stroke engine, cycle is completed in two stroke of piston in one revolution of crankshaft. So one revolution of crankshaft, one revolution equal to two strokes. What are the two strokes? From top dead center to the bottom dead center, bottom dead center to the top dead center. So that is. And coming to the heavier flywheel needed, but the lighter flywheel can be used here. Coming to the power produced for same size of engine is less. So coming to the two stroke engine, power produced for same size of engine is twice. Here is less, here is twice. And the volumetric efficiency is more due to more time for induction. So but here the volumetric efficiency is low due to lesser time for induction. So what is meant by volumetric efficiency? So first thing is the volumetric efficiency, the mechanical efficiency for our unit work done. So that is the main thing here I discussed here. And coming to the, we have to observe here. So this is the animation and the comparison of the four stroke engine to the two stroke engine. We have to see here, this is the four stroke in the sense of intake stroke, second one is compression stroke, third one is power stroke, fourth one is exhaust stroke. And coming to the two stroke engines, so we have to observation here, the upward direction and the upward stroke and the downward stroke. So this is the comparison of today's class. And coming to the summary, So first, what I have today, what we discussed is, first thing is components of two-stroke IC engine and different types of IC engine components we are discussing, and the comparison of four-stroke IC engine and two-stroke IC engine. And third point is what we discussed, the advantages of two-stroke, advantages two-stroke engine, IC engine. And fourth point is disadvantages of two-stroke IC engine. That is, and now I am going to, now next class I want to